In one of the previous videos, we have shown you an example of generating invoice with the use of data from SharePoint library. In this part, we'll demonstrate that you can also obtain data from the SQL database with the use of SharePoint workflow extension for SharePoint. In this example, only invoice number, customer name, description, and transaction value will be stored in SharePoint. Client's address and email will be received from database corresponding to the client's name. When adding a new element into the library, workflow will access database and obtain the data. Thus, both data from the SharePoint and SQL database will be used in the final invoice. So, let's open the workflow from the previous example. To receive information from database, we will use action execute SQL command from the part development. Generate SQL request. Select fields, email, and address from the table clients for entry. Which value of clients field corresponds to the client's name in the element of SharePoint library? Indicate connection string to client's database. This variable will contain array with received data, and there is quantity of affected rows. We need to find one entry in SQL database. Now, we need to check if the required client is found in the database. To do this, check the value of available records affected. If it is equal to 1, then we have found the required element. If such entry is present and it is the only one, then workflow must resume work. Unfortunately, SharePoint Designer does not make it possible to perform multi-selection. That is why we will relocate actions one by one. If the client is not found, or there are several clients in the database, we'll write an error record into the workflow log. Now, we will save receive values from the database in separate variables. To do this, we use action get array item. Element with index nil and array contains email. And element with index 1 in array contains address. Previously, we used data from SharePoint to indicate client's address. Now, we will use the value received from the database. The same we will do for the current value of email in the to field. Workflow is ready. We will save and publish it. And now we will test it. Add new element into the library. Indicate only invoice number, client's name, description, and other data. Watch over workflow history. Processing has been complete. Message has been sent successfully. We can't see the message with indicate subject and attachment in PDF which contains data filled in with the use of workflow. Address and email have been obtained from SQL database and the remaining data from the SharePoint library. In invoices folder, we can see the saved PDF file. I hope this video was informative for you, and I would like to thank you for viewing.